All right, here we go with round one. Derek Lewis, the Black Beast, is ready to go. He's worked very hard on his conditioning. He's fought a lot of five-rounders in the UFC. Don't let the frame fool you. This is a guy who has the stamina to sustain into the championship rounds if we need to go there. And now leather being thrown on both sides. All right, early action here, and a nice hook by the boxer gets home on the kickboxer. This is exactly the range in which he wants to be fighting.
Yeah, because it limits the kickboxer, and the kickboxer has a very high guard. So if you're tight, you just pivot with the hook, it lands around that guard, and he does a lot of damage with it.
Yeah, left hook found its target. And follows up with another one. Oh, how clean is that jab by Rosenstruck? All right, champ, starting to see some swelling upstairs now.
Well, he's taking way too many shots to the head. You gotta move your head. You cannot be on a straight line. Otherwise, you will take shots, and that shot, and those shots, leads to your face starting to swell.
Ho! Big right hand. Straight right is there. Back and forth we go. All right, so perhaps he's gonna have to address something defensively. There is a legitimate cut around his eye.
Yeah, he got cut on the eye from that last strike. He's gotta pay attention now before it gets worse. Oh, he's wobbling now. Man, what a fight.
Rosenstruck's shot is blocked. Just over 3 minutes to go. Rosenstruck's pretty swollen now in that jaw area. It doesn't appear to be affecting him all that much, but he's absorbed a lot of strikes to the head. Got to figure out a way to raise the guard and be more defensively sound. Oh, they're trading huge shots here. We'll see who's the last man standing. Throwing that jab now again, the fighter evades. Well, he continues to stay busy. What do they say, DC? Punches in bunches?
Punches in bunches. He's landing upside his opponent's head over and over again. Nice kick. Yep. Again.
Beautiful diving strike lands.
He's going after that cut over and over again.
That'll do it! The Black Beast strikes again!
Holy.
Make the bad man stop. A nice stoppage win for him here tonight. And the other side just couldn't handle the incoming assault. A flurry of punches, most of them upstairs. And when those big shots land repeatedly, the referee has no choice but to step in and call the fight. Bruce Buffer has the official decision.
Ready.
All right, here we are inside the home of the New York Knicks. It is Madison Square Garden, and I think a lot of people remember when Conor McGregor and Eddie Alvarez ushered in this building as far as the UFC is concerned back in 2016.
I mean, that place was insane when Conor McGregor became the UFC's double champion. From outside of the arena, you build up to the fight, to in the arena when Conor became the king. This was a great moment in the world's greatest event. Look, the best fights in history have happened here. And on that night, Conor McGregor etched his name in stone.
Big power shot there. Rock 'em, sock 'em out of the chute here. All right, early in the fight here, and Nate Diaz off to a pretty good start, found a home for that left hand.
I mean, and it's powerful. It does not seem like Nate is throwing it hard, but he always finds his target and very accurate with that straight left hand. So he kind of feeds the right hand to get you moving where he wants, and then bang, he drops that straight left on you that hurts so many. Hurt Conor McGregor, and he hurt the welterweight champion, Leon Edwards, in the same way.
All right, so look at that. A cut has been opened around that eye area.
He's taking shots over and over again to that area, and now he's dealing with a cut. These boys are standing right in front of each other, just kind of going at it.
Keeping busy now, connecting with those punches. Pocket presence and punches and pressure and pace. It's a lot of keys, but when you're fighting Nate Diaz, you better be prepared because he is coming and he is not stopping until the final hit. Oh, nice job defensively there to get the guard up. Shot is blocked by Diaz. Left hand counter there.
Oh!
All right, so that opened up a cut around his eye area.
He hasn't moved his head well. He was taking shots too clean, and now a cut has opened up.
All right, well, he rocked him pretty good, but didn't sort of smell blood in the water, and now his opponent's back in the fight.
I mean, blood's in the water. You gotta go get it. You gotta go find the finish. You cannot let him off the hook like that, because now he will be motivated to try to go hurt you as you open.
Oh, connects with another uppercut. I'm surprised his opponent's head stayed up.
Oh, he hurt him again! Oh, my goodness, what a fight.
Slips the punch nicely there. All right, so a wise decision by him to continue to attack that cut, and it's getting wider by the minute.
It's getting wider by the minute. This guy is a fantastic fighter. He's as smart as they come. So the moment that cut opened up, you knew that that would become his focus, and we are seeing it very clear right now.
Both fighters throwing heat now. Lands a nice 1-2. Well, now if you're the opponent, you really got to be careful as Diaz is able to find a home for that right hand yet again.
When Diaz starts landing the right hand, you have got to stay firm. You have got to dig your heels in the ground and say, no way you're going to just run me over. Easier said than done when you're facing Nathan Diaz.
Well, I think I can smell the blood at this point in time. That canvas didn't look like that a few fights ago. Blood is flowing from that cut with every passing strike.
Every strike. And it burns.
Nice jab by Diaz.
He's got to start kicking. Kicking the body, kicking the head. He's just got to start kicking. Oh, my goodness.
Oh, we're getting a finish here. Oh! So holding on to him here, not doing a ton, perhaps just looking to recover. Really smart approach by the offensive fighter, badgering that cut. More blood by the minute.
If head movement wasn't important early, it's very important now because that cut has gotten a lot worse.
All right, so the uppercuts have been a big part of the storyline in this one, but the setups have really been key for him. He's not telegraphing that strike, and the opponent hasn't been able to adjust.
He has not been able to see them. It's a very tricky punch, especially in the way that he throws it. He throws it at a time when you expect so many different strikes, but it's because he has such a vast knowledge of just finding that strike.
Final seconds here of round one. So far. All right, so the round is over. You see, obviously, the fighter has a cut on his cheek sustained in that round, but better to be below the eye than above it. The cut man is in there trying to close it up. All right, so there's the horn signifying the end of the round. We had a knockdown there, but not a knockout.
No, it wasn't a knockout, but you can't take those shots. That big punch landed, and it sat him down. If he gets hit with another one of those, it might be good night, Irene.
You ready to fight? Ready.
Second round underway. Do you believe it? This next round is underway. In the previous round, both fighters got rocked. Crowd going. This could do it. Oh, big left hook there.
He's hurting him bad, man. That right hook is nasty. He blocked that punch.
Diaz's face is a hot mess, man. That cut on his cheek is getting worse by the minute and worse with every...
He's hurt! He's hurt!
Oh, he's hurt! Oh, huge left! Well, you know this is the hurt business, and both guys are compromised at this stage of the fight.
Yeah, both guys are compromised. Both guys have been beat up. Both guys have done a great job of landing, recognizing what they wanted to get done, and it's showing. This is a very evenly matched fight.
Nice jab there by Diaz. Well, some might describe this as critical condition. That eye is absolutely mangled. I wouldn't be surprised to see us get a stoppage here soon.
Yeah, I mean, John, you look at his face. He's been beaten up for a very long time. I could see the doctor coming into the ring, looking at the cut and saying, I've seen enough.
Well, this is getting hard to watch, and sometimes you hear us say a fighter is too tough for their own good. Anybody want to save this athlete, right?
Yeah, this is a classic case of that, where a guy is just too tough. He's not going to win this fight. He may as well throw in the towel. I mean, this...
We'll get back to his feet yet again. Oh, but not a good look for the judges here. Look how wobbly he is. Just over 3 minutes now to go in round two. Some nice power there with the left hook upstairs.
When he gets close and he throws, he lands.
Pretty good strike there, but not a ton of meat on the bone. Kind of looks like me at the Boca Raton Boxing District.
He's used everything he could early in the fight, and now he's just in survival mode.
Obvious redness on the right side of his body.
Oh, he got him again.
His uppercut is blocked. Looked like for a minute he had a window there. It closed quickly. Ooh, big knee.
Oh, uppercut.
Trying to stay in this fight. What a great fight. Damage doled out on both sides. Perhaps some bonus money coming the way of these two individuals at 19.
50K, baby. Somebody's getting paid. These two guys are doing a great job in a fight that is so competitive. That is so evenly matched. These two really will be proud of the effort that they have shown inside the octagon. Watch yourself. Watch yourself. That was the hit. Nice fight. He heard him again.
Was just a gorgeous shot to end the fight right there. I'm not even sure the opponent really saw it coming. So back to the drawing board for him. But for the winner, this is certainly exactly what he was looking for here tonight. And here once more with the official decision is Bruce Buffer.
Ladies and gentlemen, referee Herb Dean has called a stop to this contest at 3:11 of round number 2, declaring the winner by knockout.